Welcome to the lick of the day for October 5th, 2011. Today I'm going to be talking about a rockabilly lick made famous by James Burton when he played with Ricky Nelson, before he played with Elvis Presley, and then Gram Parsons, and then Emmylou Harris, and which is interesting to me because I've just been out on the road with Emmylou Harris. And we just did Hardly Strictly Bluegrass Festival in San Francisco, which is one of my favorite things to do. Played a bunch of dates in California and Arizona, and then I flew out to New York City to meet Rodney and play at B.B. King's, and it was a reunion of sorts with our band that we had with Jenny Scheinman. We had Tim Lunsell on upright bass, and then it was big playing with my band Friday at Moe's in Daphne, Alabama, right down there by Mobile Bay. And I'm going to be playing Saturday at Bayfest in Mobile. It's my first time to play that festival, and I'm playing with the band. So come out and see me. I've got this new headstock tuner by Planet Waves. It's a micro headstock tuner. It clamps right between the nut. The nut and the low E tuner. So it's real convenient and almost invisible to your audience, but yet it works really well. So here's my telly. Okay. My dog's out there barking. I'll see him. Just let him bark for a minute. And then we'll let him in. So today's lick is appropriate to have a dog barking because it's a rockabilly lick made famous by the great James Burton from Shreveport, Louisiana. And so let's see if I can back that up just a little bit more so that you can see what I'm doing. So here's my left hand. I'm playing with my thumb and I'm sliding up to that A. Okay, so here we're going to play it. Here's the lick. Ready? Rockabilly. Go, cat, go. Just a made-up ending, but anyway, the lick is really just like your. So you can play it with a pick or with pick and fingers, which I think that's what Burton would do. You can play it with your bare fingers too, which is fun. Records, I go to Grimey's, and happy lick of the day. See you next week. Got more solo and band gigs of my own coming up, so I'm real happy about that.